In this lesson, we're going to show how to create text strokes in Webflow, and we'll break this down into two parts, adding a text stroke and sort of animating a text stroke. Part one, adding a text stroke. Now, a common pattern with text strokes is to add a stroke to the text with the fill being transparent. So with this heading selected, let's first make the fill transparent, and that's it. Unfortunately, this is completely illegible, so let's add a text stroke. Under More Type Options, we'll go down to Stroke and we'll increase the width, and still nothing. That's because it's inheriting the text color, which is transparent. So let's change the color to something more appetizing. Done. So that's an example of adding a text stroke. Now you can pair this, of course, with background color. You can even clip a gradient to the text and do all sorts of things using CSS properties in the style panel. But for our next section, let's talk about animating a text stroke. Now, this one requires an interesting CSS workaround because by default, a stroke in CSS for something like text can't be animated. You can't animate the distance or the width. So we're going to do something a little bit different. We've done the same thing here in terms of setting a stroke and no fill on this text. You can see that the fill is set to transparent, but what if we add a text shadow? When we do, it looks not fantastic, but if we change the color, and more importantly, if we change the blur, just set the blur to zero, even the distance, set that to zero, now the text shadow itself becomes something that looks like a fill. Now, what happens if we hover over either of these? Well, nothing, because we have to actually animate it. So in the hover state, if we go up and switch from none to hover, we're going to do two things to make this happen. One, going back down to our more type options here, let's move that text shadow. We'll go in and we'll actually change that distance. So we're now separating the shadow from the text stroke. And we can, of course, adjust the angle and make it look exactly how we want it to look. And the second and final thing we want to do is add a transform. And because we've moved the distance of the shadow, or what looks like the text fill, we now want it to move. So down to effects, we want to add a transform to the entire thing, which will move everything 2 pixels to the left, and of course, 2 pixels up. Hover state, done. Now, what is all of this going to do? Well, let's escape out, and now if we hover over, we see the separation happening. But we still haven't done what we came here to do. If we look at the chapter title, it says something different. That's the wrong chapter title. Also the wrong title. Also the wrong title. Also the wrong, that's the one. So what we'll do here is animate the text stroke, and we'll add 2 quick transitions. Remember, we're doing this in none, so we'll make sure we're in none, and we'll add 2 transitions. The first transition will animate the text shadow. So we'll just add one and switch the transition type to text shadow all the way up here. And of course, we can adjust our duration here. And we're gonna do the same exact thing with one more property, and that of course is the transform. So if the text shadow is animating that sort of fill effect, then the transform is going to animate the move effect. So we'll wanna make sure the transition type is transform. And of course, we can configure that transition however we want as well. In this case, let's just match it to the duration for the text shadow transition. Now, what's the result? Well, if we go over to preview, we can see still nothing's happening. That's because we have to actually hover over these links. And when we do, we can see the final animation on both of our links. But that is it. Again, we can add a text stroke to anything that's text by going to More Type Options and setting properties for that text stroke. And we can animate a text stroke, or rather create an effect that moves the element, that moves the text, while using something like a text shadow to create a fill. But that's using text strokes in the Webflow Designer.